and welcome. This is Nasreen Sheikh and you're watching It's Tomorrow News. Scores injured as tornado and heavy rain hits KwaZulu in South Africa. VENICE flooded by highest tide in 50 years. Storm in Ohio claims at least 6 lives. A tornado left a swathe of destruction in New Hanover and Greytown, north of Pietermaritzburg in South Africa on Tuesday. Residents of Mshwati district were hit hard by the tunnel of wind that blew through the area's uprooting trees in its wake. The KZN Department of Cooperative Governance and Traditional Affairs said disaster management teams had been dispatched to New Hanover and fears of possible of deaths and missing people. Scores of people were injured, said the department, adding that homes and public infrastructure had been damaged. Preliminary reports received by the department indicate that a number of people who sustained injuries in the incident are receiving medical attention from surrounding hospitals. A number of homes have collapsed, countless trees have been uprooted, and the electricity supply in the area has been interrupted. Our teams is working hard to provide support to the affected communities. Here are some live videos footage that was shot by some local amidst the ongoing catastrophe. We can see the tornado ripping through a field with fierce winds. South African Weather Service forecaster confirmed that there was a severe storm in the New Hanover and Greytown area. It was a supercell and a tornado formed. He saw the severity of the storm on the rapids and the wind speed. It was on average about 20 to 35 km per hour. "This is very strong," he said. The storm headed north, but he could not say with certainty whether the tornado would continue to those areas. The atmosphere apocalyptic seems was recorded by deliver passing by and later verified by South African weather, rainfall and storm reports. The latest data reveals that the tornado moved south of Pietermaritzburg. The extreme weather continues to batter the east coast. Three people have been confirmed dead since the weekend as relentless rainfall continues to damage properties and creates hazardous conditions for locals. Things are only getting worse in KZN. Two disaster management teams were placed on high alerts following a warning by the South African Weather Service, which said severe thunderstorm could lead to localized flooding in large parts of the province this week. Residents have been warned to take precautions as the weather continues to worsen, with heavy rains expected in the Ugu district and Thekwani Metro, which pose the risk of localized flooding. Residents in low-lying areas have been urged to seek shelter on higher ground. Rescue teams are on the ground and were urging residents to be cautious and to double-check the weather forecast before making long journeys. They were appealing to parents and teachers to ensure scholars proper routes going to and from schools. Disaster management teams are assessing and verifying incidents that have been reported to them. The heavy rain that has left Durban since Sunday has resulted in mudslides, road closure and several vehicle accidents. On Monday, city authorities were forced to shut the busy M4 highway between Umanga and the Sibaya precinct after parts of the road flooded. It is understood that the storm water drains were also causing flooding in the Pinetown area west of the city. Venice in Italy was hit by the highest tide in more than 50 years late on Tuesday, with tourists wading through flooded streets to seek shelter as a fierce wind whipped to up west in St. Mark's Square. The exceptionally intense aqua alta or high water peaked at 1.87 meter as the flood alarm sounded across Italy's iconic city of canals, the tide monitoring center said. "Everyone has been mobilized to cope with the emergency," Venice mayor tweeted. "Only once since record began in 1923 has the waters crept even higher, reaching 1.94 millimeter in 1966. The Coast Guard laid on extra boats to serve as water ambulances. Water taxis attempting to drop people off at the glamorous and historic hotels along the Grand Canal discovered the gangways had been washed away and had to help passengers clamber through windows. Snowy weather and without conditions were blamed to multiple pileups in Ohio in US, and at least two deaths on Tuesday's day after at least four people were killed in dangerous travel conditions caused by a snowstorm that swept through the plains and Midwest. Whiteout conditions also caused a pileup involving as many as 85 vehicles on State Road 8 north of Elkhorn, Ohio, according to officials. Five people had minor injuries, the report added. The snow had diminished as the system moved east on Tuesday, but school districts from Austin, Texas to Buffalo, New York delayed or canceled classes. More than 70 schools were closed in Vermont, New Hampshire, and New York, according to Vermont Public Radio. On Monday morning, an American Airlines flight slid off a snowy runway after landing at Chicago's O'Hare International Airport. The snowstorm, which has been named Winter Storm Caleb by the Weather Channel, caused hundreds of flights to be canceled and made travel difficult on roadways across the upper Midwest. Snow fell from Colorado and southeast Wyoming to northern New England. That's all for now. For more news updates, stay tuned with us. It's Tomorrow News, Nasreen Sheikh. For more weather updates like this, do like, share, and subscribe our channel.